And it's Halloween, ladies and gentlemen, here on the Fantasy Football Factory. And I'm here to tell you that we're going to fucking bitch slam you and throw you around and fuck your mamas and stay. Okay, anyway, what's up, you guys? I love your costumes, by the way, guys. I love it, I love it, I love it, man. My favorite holiday of the whole year is here, man. What's up, guys?
Hey, what's going on?
Happy Halloween!
I love this time of year, man. It's time to not be yourself and be yourself all at the same time. So,
okay, I love it, Captain Spaulding. Looking good there, bro.
Don't forget to take home some of my tasty fried chicken. Ha ha! It just tastes so damn good.
Nailed it. Nailed it. And what's up there? I like your name tag, man. Back out there, you go. Look, my name is Rob, and you're a dead motherfucker. I like the shirt, too, by the way. That's a great t-shirt. I'm fine. As a t-shirt, I love it.
As long as you can hear me, I'm fine, man.
I love your mask, and I can hear you so far, right? Can you hear him, Jay? Can you hear him?
Oh, yeah. He sounds good, man. He's scary looking as shit, but outstanding. I mean, he's all right.
Loud and clear, sir. Loud and clear.
Outstanding. Well, happy Halloween out there, football freaks and crazy motherfuckers, ready for week 9 of the fantasy football season is here already, and with it comes costumes and candy and all that good and fun shit, and I'm excited about it, man. I'm looking forward to the rest of the season, even though my team sucks. I got a couple of fantasy teams that are middling in there. I took some heartbreaking losses this week, by the way, but we will get into that later.
Cry somewhere else.
What'd you learn in week 8, guys? What'd you learn, Bean?
The Rams are a much better team with Puka and Cup back in the helm, right? They looked awesome.
Wow, what a difference.
Patriots, being the homer as usual, a little bit torn. You want to beat the Jets. The Jets suck. But then, the draft position goes, we went from first pick to who knows now, maybe fourth or fifth. So
that's right. Bad. Oh, but it had to feel good to beat the Jets, though.
It did. It just seeing Rodgers' face, blaming everybody but himself again. That's amazing.
Again, he's a cunt.
See you next Tuesday.
It's not my fault.
Yeah, Devontae, I don't know why he went there, man. I mean, unreal, right?
Crazy.
Oh, wow.
Crazy, man.
From suck to suck.
This team sucks. Take me home.
The Browns were entertaining. They were fun to watch. You can root for them now without the rapist there.
You can root for them without that dickhead back there.
Exactly. That was awesome. Jameis, man, are you kidding me? With the Eminem quotes and what an awesome story, right?
Dude, if you're a Browns fan, aren't you thinking, like, wait a minute, we had a dude that could come in and throw 300 yards and a few touchdowns on the bench all this time while we're dealing with this dickhead? What the fuck?
I mean, really, what the actual fuck?
Imagine if Cooper was still there.
Unbelievable.
I think Cooper would have been better off there than in the Bills, to be quite honest. I mean, the Bills aren't really utilizing him yet. I mean, it's early, don't get me wrong.
Right, yeah.
A couple more things. The Lions were once again very bored and had the running backs throwing touchdowns. Whatever, we're just making up shit as we go along.
Dan Campbell don't give no fucks.
I don't give a fuck.
52 points again.
Yeah, bro.
And it was nice to see Tua back. Obviously, the skilled players are happy. And he did have a breakaway where he rushed it, and he had slid. So that was good to see and not get killed, literally killed on the field.
Yeah, everybody was holding their breath.
I was watching it. I was like, no! Hey, he slid. All right.
Yeah, man.
Here we go.
That's what I learned from week 8.
I learned that Dallas is trash again.
Oh, yeah, dog shit trash.
Yeah, they're trash. I'm
Dak
sorry.
Dak is overpaid as fuck.
I know your team, but I mean,
The truth is the truth.
Where I come from, we have a word for garbage like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They suck.
Ravens are not who we thought they were.
But they are who we thought they were.
Winston, the game he had was awesome. But if you watch the game, he tried to give that ball away
many times.
And they dropped the ball many times.
The Ravens secondary is trash.
It could have had 4 picks, man, for sure.
The end of what I learned, Lions are real. Again, nobody wants to face them. We've got everything. Let's go. We're taking over the North this week against Green Bay.
Fuck yeah. Very likely.
Let's fucking go!
Well, what I learned, if we'll stay in Detroit for a minute, is that your boy fucking Williamson likes to party, right? What the fuck?
Oh, wow.
God damn. We like to party. Hey, get arrested and doing every fucking drug in them fucking known under the... I want to hang out with this dude.
And let the good times roll.
Not just one gun, two guns.
Yeah, right. Hey, two guns, baby. So they're going to call him Two Gun Sally, it sounds like.
Yeah, he's about to be dropped from my team, Sally.
He might be sitting on the bench for a minute and getting suspended for a little bit longer. Yeah, we shall see.
You can hide, but you cannot hide.
Number two thing I learned is that Dak is overpaid. Overpaid as a motherfucker, man. That dude, if you look at every Dallas loss this year, the turnovers in the red zone are 100% on Dak and 100% responsible for them getting their ass beat the way that they have.
This hole will suck forever. What a fucking joke.
Davante Adams went to his boy Rodgers so far. I know it's early. They've done nothing together. It does make me wonder if the Rodgers days might be over, but we'll get to that in a second. I want to ask you guys a little bit about that in detail in a moment.
What's that? Looks like foreshadowing?
And also, I learned that Devin Singletary, well, it looks like losing his job.
They took our jobs!
Definitely losing his job. He came in with high capital on some of the early drafts this year, and he is not delivering. So we'll look at a little bit of that. But there you go. That was a little bit of looking back at week 8. The Hail Mary. We got to talk about the Hail Mary pass, man. What did you guys think of that?
That couldn't have happened to a better team. Yeah. As a Lions fan, I loved it. I was like, oh, man, please. And the fact that I love Jaden Daniels anyway. The dude threw it from his own 35-yard
line. Dude, he put some air on it. That was a hell of a throw,
so much time, dude. I love that kid. So, yeah, couldn't have happened to a better team. And, hey, the Hail Mary.
What was the corner's name, man? What was the safety dude's name? Tyreek Stevenson? over there talking shit to the fans while the play was developing. Mm-hmm. And then he's the guy that tosses it back to Noah Brown, man. Motherfucking, yeah. What a douche. Live action karma.
Instant karma. Yeah, John Lennon was loving it.
Yeah, I mean, it should have never gotten that way. I mean, you know, you got the ball. There's no timeouts. This is the stuff you learn in, like, Pop Warner and JV in high school. Like, protect that sideline. You know, and I know I'm sure everybody's heard the experts talking about, but it's true. I mean, it's just common sense. Yeah. You protect the sideline. What do? They get 13 yard out. Boom, goes out of bounds. Then he has a chance to throw the Hail Mary, and they rush three. What did Detroit do, last week against the 2 weeks ago against the Vikings when they were trying to Hail Mary? They rush five. You got a sack. Coaching. It comes down to coaching. The players are missing that, screwing up, but simple stuff, man. And you tip the ball down. You don't jump up and hit it up. I mean, just stupid shit.
So, hey, please remember, try not to be such a douchebag.
The videos on, like, TikTok and all the social media of both Washington and Chicago fans all week have been goddamn hilarious, man. The watching live time, you know, seeing that shit has been wild. So
the internet is a wonderful place.
It really is, man. I enjoy it thoroughly. So that's what we're doing here. Well, what about Aaron Rodgers? Are we seeing the end of this dude right now? What's happening?
Bitch.
Nah.
I think it's fun just seeing him go down like this. You know, all that talk.
Yeah.
Brought all his friends.
Couldn't happen to a nicer guy.
No. What a douche. Right? He brought all his buddies, even went out and, you know, got Devontae, and they were better off last year. As a brother.
Right.
The highest expectation of this team in probably 2 decades, and they have the same record as the Patriots, who probably have the worst going into the season. You're like, oh, this is going to be the worst year.
Yep.
Yeah, right. That's right. Yeah.
And they're both same record, so go figure.
Oh, no! We suck again!
And Aaron Rodgers-led team is in the running for the first draft pick right now, so.
Exactly. So good luck, buddy. Go to your Zen Buddha, whatever.
Bullshit. Yeah, that's right.
Fucking
ayahuasca!
You know how I feel about Aaron Rodgers. He's a freaking joke. He's taking that franchise down with him because too many people's listening to him because he's Aaron Rodgers, but that's what I got for Aaron Rodgers.
He's the coach now, bro. I'll tell you what, he's the guy that time after time after time again has demanded the most money he can squeeze out of a team and then bitches about there being a lack of talent around him. Like, what the fuck? How do you think that happened, man? It might be because you took all the money, fuckhead.
It's never his fault.
No, fucker.
Nothing's his fault,
He's a mess.
Everybody else.
He's a dick piece.
Fuck that guy.
Fuck yeah. Well, there you go, man. That is where the good shit lives here on Halloween. Let's get into our proppies. I went ahead. I'll start off with mine, man. I went for a 2 touchdowns each from 4 different players.
Oh, boy.
Look at this fucking guy.
Is my prop bet. So I need 2 touchdowns from all 4 of these guys or my dick is waxed. Okay, you ready? We got Saquon Barkley. Saquon is playing against Jacksonville. I like him for 2. I got Kenneth Walker Jr. playing against the Rams. I like him for two. I got James Cook of Buffalo running against Miami Dolphins defense. And I like Justin Jefferson against the Indianapolis Colts secondary this weekend.
That's beautiful.
I like him for two, man. Two apiece across the board. I'm going double, double, double for a little bit of double that money, man. Let's go.
Boom, boom.
Yeah, boom, boom, boom. Everybody say hail. Hail. There we go. Fuck yeah. All right. What do you got? Who did you got any proppers? You got any proppers for me, Mr. Bean? Look what you got in the proper area.
I did. Unfortunately, the site I was using didn't have the Sunday games yet today. So
them cunts.
Bullshit. They only had the Thursday in the Dallas game for some reason. So I just did some money lines. I did a bunch of teams that I just think are going to win. Straight up. Jet, Ravens, Bills, Bengals, Washington, the Eagles, the Lions, the Rams, and the Vikings. $10 nice. Will be $320 to pay out.
Fuck yeah, $10 bet, $320 if every one of them team wins, and I like it a lot, man. I love every single one of those picks.
That's it.
That's money. I smell money in the air, motherfuckers.
We don't have to worry about money no more. And I said, that's good. One less thing.
It might be chocolate. All right, wait. It might be chocolate. It might be chocolate.
Life was like a box of chocolates.
You know what? I'm going, like, go back into the cookie jar, like I said last week. I mean, if you want to do something with Khalif Raymond.
Throw a couple down on an anytime touchdown from that dude. I got to give you love right here, right now, Jay. You did call that last week right here on this program. You said to pick him up and utilize him. Yep. He got a return touchdown and a receiving touchdown. That's money, brother. That's good
yes,
shit.
Yes, sir, man. He did.
Props to you. Nice call, Jay. Nice call. Nicely
Thank
done.
Thank you very much.
That's nicely done.
Give me your DraftKings lineup, sir.
All right, well, we're going to start with quarterbacks for $6,400 versus the 27th-ranked Dallas Cowboys, Kirk Cousins.
I love that pick.
My first running back is Saquon Barkley for $8,200 versus Jacksonville. That's a no-brainer.
I love Barkley this week a lot.
I went David Montgomery. I got to get Knuckles in there.
Red, he's a goal line fucking thief, man.
Yeah, he's $6,500. And I've got the wide receivers. My first one is Josh Downs because I really like Flacco being back in the
line. Me too. I might have Downs in my lineup too.
Back to the cookie jar for Khalif Raymond.
Yeah.
$3,900.
Still priced low, baby. Still priced low.
Still priced low. Take advantage of it. And yeah. For my third wide receiver, I took Devontae Smith. For my tight end, I took K-Dot. They got to throw it to somebody. I mean, if McMillan can't do it, they got to do it. So
that's a good pick. Yeah.
Cedric Tillman looks good for the Browns.
Yeah,
right?
Man. Winston's going to go to him, too, it looks like. Yeah, so
it's just he and Njoku. So let's see who gets it. And he looked great.
I love
And it. Here you go, Bean. Got one for you. I'm taking your Patriots at $3,000 against Tennessee, the 32nd ranked. So
take advantage, man. Take advantage.
I don't blame you one damn bit, man. I like that matchup and I like that lineup to get it that money in the air, baby. I like
Sometimes
it.
Sometimes you gotta take some chances and pick people that nobody else does.
And stick your banana in it.
I think he means it gives him a boner, but I don't speak German.
What about you, Bean? What'd you do? Fantasy, DraftKings, or FanDuel?
FanDuel, sir. FanDuel.
Oh, all right. He got a FanDuel coming at me this week. Talk to me.
The newly appointed Joe Flacco back in office here. $7,000.
He's not dead yet.
Nice. The price is right.
The goal line thief, Raheem Mostert. For Miami, getting all the goal line, Gary.
Nice.
For $6,400. Madison, the only target really in Vegas these days from the running back.
Yeah, no shit.
He's catching a lot of balls. $5,900. Went a little big on receiver, Puka Nacua, who's back and getting 1,000 targets. $8,100. Cedric Tillman again at $6,100. Jordan Reed, I think, might have a big day. $7,300. Kyle Pitts, who had a big week. Two, 3 weeks in a row now.
He's been resurrected.
$6,000. He's still pretty low, I thought. Flex and Jameer Gibbs at $8,500.
Wow, nice.
The Eagles D against the hapless. You know, they're going to be banged up. The Jags, they lost three of their receivers, all three of their main receivers this week.
Yeah. We've preached against the Eagles defense all year, except for last week and this week coming, man. These are two prime matchups for streaming the Eagles defense out there, too, man, if you guys are streamers.
What the fuck did you just call me?
All right. Well, I went FanDuel as well, man. And my FanDuel lineup was my balls on your tonsils.
That sounds salty.
I started Bo Nix at 7,200 against Baltimore's awful, awful, awful secondary, man. If Winston showed us anything, he definitely showed us that that secondary is some trash.
Oh, I like it.
That is their weakness. That is going to be their Achilles heel, I'm betting, right now. I would start a James Cook for 7,900 from the Buffalo backfield against the Miami defense because there is no run defense in Miami. I went with Chase Brown at 6,300 for the Cincinnati Bengals against the Raiders. If you can get past Crosby, you can run all day on them motherfuckers. I also went with Downs. I love Downs this week for Indy against Minnesota, man. I think they're going to be behind. You got Flacco, who's going to be throwing the ball a lot. So I like him and to be in a position to benefit at 6,900 bucks. I doubled up on that Baltimore secondary to go with Bo Nix. I'm going with Cortland Sutton at $6,000, a mere $6,000. I like him to be used as a primary weapon against that depleted secondary in Baltimore. Next receiver, my third receiver, I'm going to go Darnell Mooney for Atlanta against Dallas at $6,700 bucks. I love him. I think him and Kirk Cousins are developing something together, my friends. For my tight end at $6,300 bucks, I'm going with Sam Laporta. I think Sam Laporta is being resurrected. I don't know if he was dealing with an injury or something early, but he looks different. He looks better. He looks more in the game, and I think I'm going to bet on it. Since I was able to save a little bit of cash there for my flex position, I'm going Alvin Kamara for the New Orleans Saints, running all over the Carolina Panthers defense this weekend. And that left me $3,900 bucks on my defense. I'm starting the Washington Commanders against Daniel Jones and the Giants.
Hey, I like that. I like it very much.
So let's go get that money. Let's go get that money. All right. Well, let's move in real quickly then, man. I know I asked for a little bit of homework, and it is Halloween, you guys. Before we closed out with our favorite horror movies for everybody, man, and I know that there's a football game here coming in here in just a little bit, man. I promise. We'll be done with you before kickoff of the Thursday Nighter this week. The Houston Jets game here in just a little bit, ladies and gentlemen. So keep hanging out with us, man. You won't miss any football, I promise.
Let's play football!
So, let's talk candy real quick, man, because I got a couple of big barrels over here we'll be handing out in just a little bit. Give me your five favorite candies. Let's go to you first, Jay. What do you got? Your five favorite candies, brother.
Well, shoot, I'm going to go with one that everybody really hates. It's a guilty pleasure. I like the candy corns.
Gross.
Oh, shit. Yeah, that would make my list of worst candies, honestly.
They're not bad.
No. Hey. Everything, including candy, is subjective, my friend.
So I'm going with that. Number four, I'm going to go with, let's go with the old tried and true with the Kit Kat. I like Kit Kats.
I love Kit Kats. Yeah, man.
For one, I have no problem with Kit Kat. Here lately, I never got any as a kid or anything, but I steal some from kids every once in a while. The sour worms, anything sour, gummy worms, sour worms, yeah. I'll take something like that.
I like it. I like it.
Very tasty. I like Rolos.
Oh, old school Rolos. Fuck yeah.
Rolos in there, and I'm sorry, everybody. I'm sure we're all maybe going to have this exact same one. You got to go with the Reese's Cups.
Yeah, I love Reese's, man.
I love a Reese's Cup.
I'm betting that's on everybody's list.
Blades in.
Nice.
Put a razor blade in there. It's an exciting cup.
Don't eat any apples you can shave with, right? That's right.
Exactly. I'm down with that.
That's really good advice.
What about you, Bean? What you got for your candies, man?
Brains.
Halloween.
I want to eat Hulk Hogan's ass.
How do I wash it out of my mind?
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to go with the Three Musketeers.
Oh, wow.
What? Ooh.
Oh, shit. Nougat. He's a nougat man.
Yeah.
That's first my candy corn.
I do like a Three Musketeers, honestly.
Milky Way comes in next. If you put him in the freezer, even better, man.
That's a nougat guy.
He's a nougat dude. Yeah, man.
Wow.
Number three is Kit Kat. Love Kit Kat.
I love a Kit Kat, too. You got to have a fucking nougat in your life, too, so.
Number two is Twix. I love Twix growing up, man.
Yeah, I love Twix too, man.
How about that Twix?
Caramel with the candy and the cookie and all. Good.
Built in two factories.
Yeah, left Twix. And number one, same as Jay. Reese's Peanut Butter Cup.
Reese's Peanut Butter Cup. Dude, wow, so if we did an overall, that would definitely be the winner of the number one spot for sure, huh? my list of top five candies, man, and honestly, it is subjective. If you ask me on a different day, I might come up with a different list. I love candy, so if you put candy in front of me, I'm going to probably eat some of it.
Like when my friend Candy was in prison, and I rode around with a van, and it just threw free candy on the side of it because I was just, you know, trying to get her out. Man.
I like it. Free candy. Well, number five for me is an old school movie theater fucking favorite as well, man, which is snow caps. I love me some motherfucking snow caps.
Oh, shit. Okay.
I will eat dark chocolate is my shit, son. And number four for me is better lay a finger off my Butterfinger because I love them shits. Me and Bart Simpson used to fist fight for them fuckers.
Kill, kill, kill.
I love a Butterfinger. For me, Reese's Peanut Butter Cup came in at number three. I do love it. And again, that's another one of those. If you put it in the refrigerator, it's even better, in my opinion, man. They have those in dark chocolate now. Holy shit. Those are the very best. The thin dark chocolate. Oh my God, they're so good.
Dropping knowledge.
That sounds good. I'll have that.
Wow, they're so good. And then number two, man, Snickers. You can't go wrong with Snickers. You pull out your dickers and you can eat a Snickers. You'll be a happy man. For me, number one is the Sweet Tart ropes. Those elastic ropes from the Sweet Tarts. They got a cherry punch flavor. Oh my God, I fucking am addicted to them things, man.
Those are good, yeah.
They hang out of my mouth like a cigarette all day in this bitch.
Yeah, I'm a sour, tasty guy, too. Yeah, I like the sour stuff.
I can't stand black licorice. I can't stand your candy corn. And Brock's used to make that Neapolitan coconut candy. Does anybody remember them shits?
I remember those.
Oh, my God. That shit is vomit-inducing dog shit. I love candy, but oh, my God. Fuck.
Man, I think I like the candy corn because I enjoyed eating the chalk from the chalkboard as a kid.
Yeah, that must be it, man. You know, if you stack up candy corn, they look like corn on the cob.
Yeah.
Guilty. Yeah, that's why you eat chalk. And what was them? Necro wafers? Those necro wafers? Them bitches.
Wafers, yeah.
If you ate chalk as a kid, you ate necro wafers.
Those were kind of cool.
Yeah, man. Fucking chalky shits. Well, it is Halloween, and there is a game coming on here in a little bit, so let's talk about some horror movies, man. Let's go to you first there, Jay. What's your number five on your horror movie list, sir?
My number five,
I love that movie.
It is so fun. The way I describe it to people is a horror movie meets Three's Company, and Mr. Furley is, he just don't know what the hell's going on, and it's one of the greatest movies
ever.
Oh, howdy ho, officer. We've had a doozy of a day. There we were minding our own business, just doing some chores around the house when kids started killing themselves all over my property.
Well, that's what happened, Tucker.
That's my number five.
That's one of Scully's favorite movies of all time right there, man.
I love it.
All right, cool. What's your number five, Mr. Bean?
Classic, The Exorcist.
You're going to die up there.
I need reassignment.
You're the best we've got.
I think I've lost my faith.
I'm Damien Karras. I'd like to help you. Where's Reagan?
In here. With us.
The power of Christ compels you!
What an excellent day for an exorcism.
Oh, you can't go wrong with The Exorcist, cool. Man. I love The Exorcist. The
book was better. I'm one of those guys. But
yeah, dude. William Blatty, man. William Blatty, baby. There you go. Good stuff. For my number five, I'm going to go with a Cronenberg classic, which is overlooked in some areas, but I loved Videodrome, man. James Woods and Videodrome. I love that fucking movie, man.
Death to Videodrome. Long live the new flesh.
I watch it every year for Halloween still. Every year.
Oh, shit.
Fucking great movie, man.
Nice. I've never seen it. So
you got to watch it, man.
Dude,
you got to watch
it. I've never seen that one. That's one I haven't seen. So
mandatory. Videodrome, man. Please watch it as soon as possible.
I think that massive doses of Videodrome signal will ultimately create a new outgrowth of the human brain, which will produce and control hallucination to the point that it will change human reality.
All right, that goes to everybody's number fours, man. What you got for your number four, Jay?
4A and 4B, these guys.
Yeah.
House of Thousand Corpses and Devil's Rejects.
Man. She got some Rob Zombie love in here tonight, man. I got Rob Zombie.
Rob Zombie love so much.
We got Bean as a zombie with a My Name is Rob sticker. I love it, man. I love it.
There's my boy right there, Captain Spaulding. I love him. He's one of my favorite horror dudes, so that's why I
respect him. Rest in peace, Captain
Spaulding. Rest in peace, Sid Haig.
got blood, violence, freaks of nature? Well, then come on down to Captain Spaulding's Museum of Monsters and Madmen. Yeah, see the alligator boy. Ride my famous murder ride. Yeah.
My dude, so.
Nice. All right. Yeah, but you got a number four, Bean.
The Nightmare Before Christmas.
Here, let me show you.
Fantastic. Tim
every
Burton.
Halloween, man. I got to watch it every Halloween.
Ah, fantastic, man. Tim Burton classic, man. You got to love it. That's a good movie to take mushrooms to, but I didn't say that.
Oogie Boogie is my man.
He's ancient. He's ugly. I don't know which is worse. I might just split a seam now if I don't die laughing first.
I love that.
For me, I'm giving a little love at number four to the character I am. Look, just like you did with Captain Spaulding.
Oh, my God. Say it.
They live, baby. They live.
Either put on these glasses or start eating that trash can.
That's my number four movie, man.
Bay.
Yeah.
I have
hey,
come
look, live off the glasses.
To chew bubble gum and kick ass.
I have come here to chew bubble gum and kick ass. And I'm all out of bubble gum.
Oh, my
all
God.
All right, there we go.
No more bubble gum around.
Yeah, that's right, and I'm all out of bubble gum. So what do you got at number three, Mr. J?
D. Wallace, The Howling.
Boom, nice, nicely done.
The Howling.
What about killing it with silver bullets?
Well, sure, silver bullets are fire. It's the only way to get rid of the damn things. They're worse than cockroaches.
Wow!
What are you kids watching?
The Newsleys turned into a werewolf.
When I was young, this was one of the movies that got me. I mean, Eddie that's in the movie, if you watch it, you'll see Eddie.
Hello, bread boy.
Okay.
Eddie?
You're not gonna hang up, are you?
You know me. Okay. And I don't know you. And why is that?
Man, he freaked me out. He was a creepy looking son of a bitch. And
with one of the best transformation scenes ever, too, by the way.
Dude, with Eddie, that's what I'm saying with that. Yeah. When he was saying, hey, bright boy, go ahead. Go ahead. Check out The Howling. She wants her burger rare.
All right, that puts you at number three. What do you got at number three, Bean?
Interview with a Vampire.
Ah, nicely done.
Oh, damn. Yeah. You're pulling out classic. Some freaking crazies.
Anne Rice, classic. All right. Fuck yeah. Nicely acted movie. You can't go wrong there, too, man.
Great cast. I mean, perfect. Perfect movie.
So you want me to tell you the story of my life? I'll tell you my story. I'll tell you all of it. I'm flesh and blood, but not human. I haven't been human for 200 years.
Fuck yeah, dude. Fuck
great
yeah.
Movie.
That Kirsten Dunst launched Kirsten Dunst's career, right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yep. Brad Pitt, yeah, Tom Cruise.
All right, well, that brings me to my number three, which is Evil Dead 2. My number three is Evil Dead 2, because it's a goddamn great movie. Ash is one of the greatest and coolest characters in movie history, my friends. I love that fucker.
Yes, sir. Bring the boomstick.
And if you're lucky a little later, I'll let you play with my boomstick.
I love it. All right, so what's your number twos? Give me your number twos. What you got, Jay?
Halloween, the original.
I spent 8 years trying to reach him, and then another 7 trying to keep him locked up because I realized that what was living behind that boy's eyes was purely and simply evil.
Nice. Very nice. Very nice. Classic.
Everybody should definitely watch this movie.
That is mandatory.
It's what started it. It's The Shape. He's got you. He's coming for you. Gotta say Halloween. You know,
Jamie Lee Curtis at her finest, my friend. Well,
oh, yeah. She's always fine.
Trading Places so fine. Might have been her finest, but you know, you get it.
Too light.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's the closest thing to perfect that I've ever seen.
She's a beautiful lady, I'll tell you. Oh, and I still love her, man. She's still kicking ass, dude. All her movies, she's still great. Yeah.
I mean, she's got irritable bowel syndrome, but she's cool.
Right. Hey, she eats that yogurt for that.
Yogurt so helps, though. Yeah.
Yeah.
So help get things working the way they should with Activia.
What do you got at number two, Mr. Bean?
The original Nightmare on Elm Street. Shit gave me nightmares when I was a kid, man.
Fuck, the original Freddy.
Freddy.
Yeah, the first Freddy was scary.
Before he got super comical and did shit.
Right. Right. He was an absolutely terrifying dude in the first movie, man. Straight up horror.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Hey, Nancy. No running in the hallway. Get you. Come to Freddy.
He became a goofy fucker over time, yeah, but he definitely was a horror fucking character in the first movie. The first movie is a horror movie for sure. And for my number two, I got The Exorcist 3.
Satan grows stronger.
You believe in possession, Father?
He has found a haven.
Come to take a little blood from your father.
He has taken possession.
The boy had been crucified.
Now, I fucking love The Exorcist 3, man. That's actually my favorite movie in the Exorcist lexicon, even, man, with George C. Scott and the fucking amazing Brad Dourif, you know, the fucking lady crawling on the ceiling in the background and shit, man. That was a creepy, great fucking movie, man. The Exorcist 3 is mandatory fucking great motherfucking movie. Love it. Forget that 2 exists. 2 is a pile of dog shit, but 3 is amazing. 3 is great.
Okay, yeah, hell yeah.
All right, which brings us down to dun dun dun, our number one favorite horror movies for Halloween 2024.
Looking back,
what do you got, Mr. J? What's your favorite horror movie, my friend?
Oh man, I worked hard on it. It was tough.
But I know it's tough. It's tough to come up with a list like this.
It's so hard to come with my. But this is a movie that I watch year round. I fall asleep to it. Return of the Living Dead.
Brain Candy. That movie's Brain Candy. I love it. Brains. Speaking of brains.
Right. Tar Man.
Medical science is back.
It's a puzzle, because technically, you're not alive.
Why do you eat people?
Not people. Brains.
Brains?
You mean the movie Live? I mean, rabid weasels. I mean, there's so much cool stuff from it.
I love that movie, dude. That's such a fun movie.
You think this is a costume? This is a way of life. Dude, this is...
fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. Yes, sir.
This is my grand poobah right here.
That's a great number one choice, man. Absolutely fantastic. What do you got at the top spot, Mr. Bean?
I got a top one just because it was something I watched every year as a kid with my best bud, and then continued the tradition with my daughter about 10 years ago. The original Halloween. It's already been brought up, but
nice.
It's classic. It's my favorite. I'll throw in number two, because we watch one and two back to back. So those are my two favorite, absolute favorite movies to watch every Halloween.
That's perfect, man. That's a perfect number. Fuck yeah, dude. You can't go wrong. Jamie Lee Curtis becoming the fucking scream queen that she
the original scream queen. I was just going to say that. Yeah, exactly, man.
Yeah.
Perfect, perfect. Well, there you go, man. That just leaves my number one, man. And I had to go with George A. Romero's Night of the Living Dead, man. Fucking the classic. It's so dark. It's so fucked up. And the black and white and the Pennsylvania town. And the ending even is so fucked up. Like, as the credits roll, you just feel so fucking dirty and gritty. And like, oh, my God, did they just end the motherfucking movie that way? You fucking cocksuckers, you know? Like, God damn it, man. But what a great fucking movie, man. On a low budget, what a great fucking movie.
Great movie. I almost had that one as one of mine, too. I was thinking about it, but here you go, buddy.
Yeah, there you go. Fucking there it is right there.
Yours. That's your number one, babe.
They're coming to get you, Barbara. Yeah.
Fuck yeah, man. And there's so many. I just recently rewatched Shaun of the Living Dead.
Oh, God.
There's so many shout-outs to Night of the Living Dead. Like, just his mother being named Barbara and everything. Like, you know, like, it's so great, man. It's so good, man.
I don't want to cause a fuss.
We're coming to get you, Barbara.
Well, on that note, man, we should probably wrap it up because I think they're gearing up for kickoff here in just a few minutes for Halloween night football. Football has taken over the holidays, man. We got Christmas. We got Thanksgiving. We got Halloween. You know, we're going to be playing on your anniversary and your birthday. We got NFL, you know, fucking, I like it. I like it.
Oh, man, it's freaking crazy, man. Football's taking over, and I couldn't be happier.
Yeah, man. All right, gentlemen. Well, it's almost time for kickoff, so I love you motherfuckers. Happy Halloween.
Love you, bro. You
thanks too. For hanging out, man. Well, what do you say? Let's come back next week and do it again?
I'm down. Let's work it.
We here at the Fantasy Football Factory are working hard for you to make sure that you're winning money while you're watching your favorite sport. So keep hanging out with us, you guys, man. We'll make it worth your time, I promise. All right, motherfuckers. We'll see you next week.
We out.
Happy Halloween. And fix your fucking life.
Fix your lives.